Next, we will proceed with the configuration of the address pool. First, enable the DHCP service. The DHCP service has been enabled. Now, let's configure the first address pool, IP pool AP. Network segment 10.1.10.0, 24 bit mask. Then we configure the gateway list. The first IP address is the gateway. Now let's configure option 43. Using sub option 3, then ASCII 10.10.10.10. This is the update source for our AYC. The next step is to exit. We can display it now. Just these three commands. Next, let's continue. We'll configure the employee address pool. Network 10.1.2.0.0. The mask is 24-bit. Then the gateway list is 10.1.20.1. Here, because we need to assign addresses to users, we need a DNS. All right, next, let's continue to configure the guest addresses. Network 10.130.1, 24-bit mask. The gateway is 10.130.1. After the configuration is completed here, if the configuration is this number, we will automatically modify it to 30.0. Continue configuring DNS. Check it, all right? Configuration is complete. Save it. Next, we need to enable the global address pool under the interface. First, enter VLAN IF10. Configuration complete. Then enter VLAN IF20 and 30. Configuration complete. Next, we need to configure the appropriate source for our CAPWAP tunnel. Our source address is loopback 0. This step needs to be configured on the AYC. This step was not configured successfully because we had previously configured the CAPWAP tunnel. Now we need to delete it. Next, let's configure loopback 0 again. This time the configuration was successful. Next, let's proceed with configuring the AP group. First, we can check the MAC addresses of the APs. Here we can see there are two APs. Their MAC addresses are as follows. Next, we need to configure MAC address authentication. Of course, first we need to create our AP group. The Huawei AP group has already been created previously. We can also check the configuration within our group. Now let's configure the authentication method for the APs. Using MAC for authentication, we can copy over the MAC addresses we noted earlier. Now we can name it AP1. Then add this AP to one of our groups, Huawei. Operation complete. Next, let's copy in the second MAC address. This AP we set as AP2, also placed in the Huawei group. Operation complete. Now let's check the status of the APs coming online. We find that the APs have not received an IP address. Why is this? Because our APs cannot communicate with the AYC. We need to set up a route on our core switch for this. Traffic to 10.10.10.10. needs to be sent to 10.60.1. On the AC, we also need a return route. After configuring, wait a moment. We can check now. Our device should be online. It has now obtained an IP address. Next, we need to configure VLAN services. First, we need to configure the SSID and security templates. Due to time constraints, I'll just show you the results of my configuration. I won't go through each configuration, configuring two SSID templates, one for employees and one for guests. Let's take a look at one for employees and one for guests. In here, our SSID profile name is employee. In this profile, we also need to configure an SSID with its own name. You see, the names employee and guest in front are the names of the profiles, which are the template names. The SSIDs employee and guest at the back are the names of the SSIDs we release. That is, these are the names of the Wi-Fi networks our users will see. Then, there's our security profile, which is our security template. Let's take another look. We configured one each for employee and guest. For employee, we used WPA2 and set a password using the PSK method with AES used for link encryption. Look here, WPA2 PSK. Then the encryption method used is AES. Now let's look at the guest, which we have set to open system. This is our policy. Next is the creation of the VAP template. In the VAP template, we need to set the SSID template and security template, as well as our business VLAN and our primary mode. Here, the employee uses the tunnel method. Let's look at our VAP template. Display, VAP, profile, name. Look here, there is a lot of information. Here, our service VLAN is 20%. Then the primary mode is tunnel forwarding. Then our SSID and security profile. Both templates are for employee. The same applies for guest. We won't continue looking here. The difference here is in the future different. Then our primary mode becomes direct forwarding for guest use. Finally, we need to set our pre-management template. For this pre-management template, we just need to set the country code to CN China, which means China. Finally, we need to enter our AP group, then bind the AP group with the pre-management template. After binding, we also need to bind our VAP template. VAP template has one for employee, then here's WLAN 1, then radio all and guest, then use WLAN 2, radio all. So now we can start using our Wi-Fi. Let's look at the signal. Here we can see the guest. Now there is a signal being released. So this is the configuration of our Layer 3 WLAN bypass networking.